Back in 2019, we did a complete breakdown of all the National Crokinole Association rules. There's a link to that video in our YouTube description. In this video, we are going to go super deep on the one rule that seems to cause the most crokinole confusion. We see questions about this over and over again. It's when the situation arises that when you go to take your shot, there are no opponent's buttons on the board, but there are one or more of the shooter's buttons on the board. Let's take a look. My name is Jeremy Tracy of Crokinole Game Boards. We are the official board builders for the World Crokinole Championships, and we have the pleasure of playing with and against the absolute best crokinole players in the world. If you find this video helpful, please like, comment, share, subscribe. It all helps to build our channel, and more importantly, it helps to build awareness of the great game of crokinole. Let's look at this rule as it is written in the official National Crokinole Association rulebook.
If there are no opposing discs in play, then the shooting disc, or at least one disc struck during the shot, must end up touching or within the 15 line. A 20 is considered to be within the 15 line.
That's pretty clear. And it's also not. So let's look at some specific examples and see what the official ruling would be in each of these scenarios. To be clear, in every example we're going to look at in this video, there are no opponent's buttons on the board, and the shooter does have a button or buttons somewhere in play. With no opponent's buttons on the board, in order for it to be a valid shot, you must play to the middle. If you do not make it into that circle, it comes up short, then your button goes into the gutter. Or if you shoot long and your button goes out the far side, that is not a valid shot, your shooter must be placed into the gutter. But all of your other buttons will stay where they were. You do not lose those buttons, as long as your shooter did not make contact with those buttons during your shot. If a shooter does make contact with a button during the shot and neither the shooter or the one that you contacted ended up in the middle, or at least touching that circle, then you would lose both of those buttons. They both go in the gutter. Let's say you hit a peg and come back and you hit your own. Your shooter and the button your shooter hit both go in the gutter. What if you have one on the far side and you accidentally pull a Super Steve and shoot all the way through and hit that button? Both are gone. What if your shooter hits one of your buttons that's not in the middle, but it doesn't hit other buttons that you have on the board? You would only remove your shooter and the buttons that were hit. The other ones, the ones that did not get contacted during the shot, would stay in play. So what if you catch a peg and come back and hit two of your own buttons? Well, that just sucks. And I don't ever want to be your doubles partner. Just kidding, sort of. Anyway, you would lose your shooter and both of the buttons that you made contact with. To be clear, if your shooter makes contact with button A, and button A then makes contact with button B, they would still all come off if it's an invalid shot, even though your shooter didn't make direct contact with button B. The rule is any buttons that got hit during an invalid shot would be removed from play. Next situation, you have a button, say it's out in the 5 or the 10, and you hit it with your shooter and bump that button up into the middle circle, but your shooter doesn't go into the middle circle. You're good to go, we're all smiles, and I might even let you be my crokinole partner. But if you attempt that famous bump and run shot and you hit your button that's on the board and it goes all the way through out the far side, or if it doesn't quite make it, and neither the button you hit or your shooter end up in the middle, you lose them both. What if you have one in the 10 and somehow, I don't know why you do this, but somehow you manage to hit that button with your shooter and your shooter goes into the center, but the button you make contact with doesn't. You're still good to go. All those buttons would stay in play. At this point, you may be saying, all right, Jeremy, I get it. I understand that either my shooter or one that I hit has to end up within or at least touching that 15, or I lose anything that's touched. I understand that at this point I may be flogging a dead horse, and I also understand that if I don't keep going and share more examples, there will be comments down below saying, well, what about this situation and what about that scenario?
You really think so?
Oh, I guarantee it. Within 24 hours, and I'll bet you it's either going to be Daniel or Jay. One of them is going to put a comment under this video that says, yeah, but come on, Jer, what if I got 3 out in the 10 and I've got 2 in the 15 and my shooter does a triple sow cow backflip, Simon the Seagull maneuver, hits the peg on the far side and ends up out in the 5? What then, Jer? Why didn't you cover that example? So yeah, we're going to keep on vlogging with just a few more examples. So if you have one somewhere in the middle and your shooter comes up short of that line, that hog line as they call it, it'll go in the gutter. Or if you shoot long and go all the way through to the other side, again, you would lose that shooter. If your shooter hits the one in the center and your shooter leaves the center but the one that was there previously remains, you're good to go, all your buttons would stay. By the same token, if you shoot and your shooter stays in the middle but the one you bumped leaves the middle, you're still good to go because one that was involved in your shot ends up within the middle. But if you shoot and your shooter knocks one that's in the center out of the center and your shooter also goes out of the center, you would lose them both. One that gets contacted within your shot must end up within that circle or at the very least touching that line. Well, there it is. I hope that we've covered enough scenarios and situations to remove as much crokinole confusion as possible. But one of the great things about this game is that there's always different scenarios and setups and situations that happen every time you play. So in summary, here's one guiding question that will help you after a shot in this situation. Did the shooter or one that the shooter touched end up within or at least touching that line? If it did, you're good to go. If not, you need to figure out which buttons to remove. Have fun with the greatest game on earth. You know what's gonna happen? There's gonna be crokinole disputes, and someone's gonna pull up this video. So half of the room is gonna love me, and half of the room is gonna hate me.
Pacific examples.
Good. Yep.
But yeah, still rolling.
Good.